Hi, my name is Travis Zajac, and Briar is my favorite puck nut.
It's time to lace up those skates and talk about hockey with Walt, Bry, Ming, and Sunday Jeff. These are the Puck Nuts.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to this week's edition of Puck Nuts, dealing with the New Jersey Devils and the NHL. My name is Ming Chen.
I'm Brian Johnson.
Walt.
Sunday Jeff.
All right, guys. Big news this week. Huge news. We're moving time slots yet again. We're moving days. Boy. Get excited. Get excited.
I feel like a fucking pinball over here.
Why do we keep getting bounced?
All right, we tried 2 weeks at Saturday, and you know, I actually thought it was very successful. I got an email.
How was it successful?
I got an email from somebody.
Tell me how you, Ming Chen, measure success.
I measure success by fan feedback.
So you got 6 emails as opposed to 3?
That's double. All right. I measure my success in percentages, not pure numbers. So I got an email from someone from Canada who was ecstatic we were moving to Saturday. They said with us being on Saturdays, they could gather their kids around in the afternoon.
This means I won't conflict with blowhard.
Was that the Canadian you got the email from?
Malcolm like hockey?
Yeah, he played hockey.
Malcolm doesn't have a family, though. Not yet. But this person said they were going to gather their family around, listen to Puck Nuts in the afternoon, and then it would go into night, and they would all be gathered already for Hockey Night in Canada, which, you know, is arguably the biggest show in Canada.
So What's Hockey Night?
It's every Saturday night. They'll show a big hockey game up in Canada. It's been running for years. It's one of their highest-rated shows.
Do you gather your kids together now for hockey night?
No, they don't have it down here. It's kind of a big It's a big Canadian thing.
Oh, we went from Saturday to Thursday now. How is that helping us?
So we're going from Saturday. Now we're on Thursday.
Bullet points indicate that it's a primo spot.
It is a primo spot. Thursday nights is traditionally, the huge spot for sitcoms. Brian,
you remember? Now we're in competition with the sitcoms.
No, we're competing. Well, sure, but
what the fuck is he talking about?
Sitcoms. You watch TV, don't you, Brian? Remember the
Cosby? We're talking about TV now?
Yeah. Well, you know, I'm comparing our ratings.
What else is on Thursday on Smodcast Network?
Just us.
It's just ours.
It was Jay and Silent Bob Get Old. We crushed them. They're being pushed aside.
We destroyed them and took their primo spot away.
That's right. So, Brian, you remember a little show called The Cosby Show?
I do. Yeah.
What night were they on?
Thursday nights. That's right. Weren't The Simpsons on originally Thursday nights, too?
I believe so.
I thought so.
And, you know, Friends? Remember a little show called Friends? I'm not a fan.
Enough with your nonsense.
Were the Seinfeld? Friends and The Simpsons and The Cosby Show of Smodcast?
Obviously, the next step is Puck Nuts has been retired and shot in the head and put out of its misery.
Come on. We've hit double digits. This is show 10. We've double
How's
digits.
The downloads
it's a,
going?
It's a milestone. We've been getting good downloads.
No, really?
Yeah, we're getting good downloads. We're still in the top 10 sports and recreation podcast. We're still the number one hockey podcast. Really? Maybe I shouldn't be touting it. I don't want to jinx it, but we're doing all right.
We got jinxes all over the place.
We got a lot of curses
going on. We're doing all right.
All right, so
I got something here.
But how's anybody going to follow us if we're bouncing all over the place, though?
It's a podcast. It doesn't happen live. You download it, you know, when you wake up, when you subscribe, and it gets downloaded automatically. All you got to do is hit play.
How old are this guy's kids that they're sitting around listening to Puck Nuts together?
He didn't say.
How do you feel about the new time slot?
I don't think it really matters. It's a podcast. You can download it whenever you want. Listen to it whenever you want. It's not a live event, so it doesn't matter if you're on Wednesday, Thursday, Sunday, Monday. It really doesn't really matter, right? If it's something that's just going to download.
I did not expect that. Yeah. I thought Sunday Jeff was going to call Kevin and tell him to go fuck himself.
Wow, very analytical there.
There are no Nielsen boxes on top of people's computers measuring shadows and shit for popularity.
No,
we're good.
I thought downloads was the
download is
the way
downloads is the best. Downloads and
emails.
So.
I checked the email the other day. We all get right. Like 2
a Puck Nuts emails
every 3 days. Yeah,
it's not that we get more than 2 every 3 days, especially when
unless you're deleting them.
I'm not deleting them.
All right,
it's not that bad. This week I'm expecting 12 emails as opposed to 6.
Because of the Thursday slot?
Yes.
What's up with the new time slot? Yeah. I'm not listening no more.
That guy in Canada's crushed. Our one big fan.
I see you've moved into primo territory, guys.
All right. This will get you excited. Okay. All right, bullet point number two. We got a couple of busted nut. And, Brian, we got some busted nuts.
Oh, wow.
Show you one of the busted nuts. Lovely lady who only wants to be known as Scarlet.
Now, is this going up on the...
This will be going up on the blog. Big fan, big...
Explain what the busted nut is.
So the busted nut is, girls in...
Can't we... Oh, okay, busted nut, not busted nuts.
Right.
Are you on to busted nuts already?
No,
I got one.
Explain what a busted nut is.
Well, let me pass this around to these guys.
Send us some more.
Got some thigh highs going on this Scarlet.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of the, fan of the thigh highs. Huge fan of the thigh highs. So, you know, if you want to add that to the repertoire, I'm not complaining.
All right. Now, did you explain what it was?
The busted nut is a creation come up that Brian came up with a couple weeks ago of girls in hockey jerseys. Send them, guys, if you're listening to the show, send a picture of your lady in a hockey jersey. Or ladies, if you're listening to the show, send a picture of yourself.
Where do they send it, man?
You will send it to pucknuts at smodcast.com. Jeff approves.
You like it, huh, Jeff?
We got some fans. Some fans out there.
And just one more here. Lovely lady in a Toronto Maple Leafs jersey.
Now, what I find strange is that none of them are wearing Devils jerseys.
Yeah,
you would think that they would have a Devils jersey. I guess they're true to their team.
We need any jersey.
Well, that's true.
But
I don't think anybody in Jersey even listens to this show. I don't think there's any Devil fans that listen to this. I'm not even fooling around.
I haven't been stopped in public and congratulated, so I'm inclined to agree with you.
All right, so if you're a New Jersey Devils fan, you're listening to the show right now, write in. Let us know. Pucknuts@smodcast.com. Just one word, two word.
But where's the busted nut?
So the busted nut is also, well, that was your creation where a guy would send in a picture of himself wearing a hockey jersey. Nothing else with his nuts hanging so low that they hang below the jersey.
Well, I mean, you only take a picture if they hang below, if they're able to hang below the jersey.
Your sack has to be distressed in order to qualify.
Right, right. You want to hang a weight off of it, or they're like that, or if they're like that naturally, send it in.
We
got some entries. Brian, you ready for this?
I'm ready.
All right,
let's see this.
There you go.
Oh man. At first, I swear I thought that was his cock to the side. Oh my god! That's what the thumbs up is pretty awesome too.
So I mean,
congratulations, Walt.
Yeah, that's pretty.
That has got to be. There's no need to send any more in.
You would think so, but I got another one. So you know, give a shout out to this guy. He didn't say not to say his name. So Bronson with the two thumbs up. Thank you very much.
You wanted his name said?
I don't know, but...
I mean, we know who that is. Bronson? That's the guy from on our show. Remember he helped Johnny Schramm?
You know this guy?
Our spokesman. Our spokesman, well, Johnny Schramm.
Nobody else could be named Bronson.
I mean...
Bronson Pinchot?
Well, now you're saying his last name.
Bronson Arroyo?
But, yeah.
You know. So, Brian, we did get another one here. Let me know what you think.
Oh my god.
And that Pittsburgh jersey, I believe, is the same one the other girl is wearing in the first picture.
The expression is genius on his face.
Oh, that dude got that girl?
Yeah. Well, come on. Wait.
With those busted nuts, he got that girl?
Wait, that's the guy that got Scarlet?
Yes. I believe they're married.
Where do they live?
Pittsburgh? Pittsburgh, I guess.
Oh, dude, this guy, even with his busted nuts, he must be one. That's impressive.
Yeah.
He didn't get her with the nuts. He had something else going.
That's great.
So thank you, guys.
Well, that's definitely been our most successful segment ever.
Yeah. Segment ever?
Keep them coming in.
And it's not over yet, but thank you for helping us celebrate our 10th anniversary. Now,
will the Busted Nuts have their own gallery on your blog?
Yeah,
or?
Absolutely.
Yeah?
Yeah, they'll be linked.
I double check because that one guy showing his face. I don't know.
I think I'll put the black bars across the eyes.
I'll do more than that. I'll just cut it from the neck.
All right, I'll do that.
Don't
Jason.
Get the guy in trouble.
All right, Jason,
Crosby's
thank you.
Crosby's face on her.
Jason Scarlett, thank you. Cindy Crosby, I like that. All right, we got a couple of shout-outs to do. One for our friends at Monarch Tattoo in Newfoundland, New Jersey. Walt, take it away.
No, I saw that there was an email from somebody who said that they took them up on the promotion.
One of the three?
Yeah, one of the three emails was a person who took them up for their Tell Them Steve Dave / Pucknuts tattoo promotion.
What was the promotion? Is it still going on?
Yeah, it's still going on. Where is it at again?
It's Monarch Tattoo is in Newfoundland, New Jersey, which is right next to the Center of Weirdness, West Milford, New Jersey.
And there, if you go in there and you say, hey, tell them Steve Dave, or hey, Pucknut.
They give me all the money out of the cash box.
you're going to get a discount on any tattoo in the place.
Right.
And these are really nice dudes, man, all right, who do this. And
you've sung their praises in the
past. Yeah, they are really nice. You know what it is, though? As somebody who doesn't have any ink, I can see going into a tattoo parlor being very intimidating. Because, you know, these guys reek toughness, people with tattoos.
I mean,
not talking about when you can visibly see the tattoos.
Mm-hmm.
You can't see any of your tattoos. But when somebody's showing ink, it's almost like it's like bigger muscles are underneath that ink. So it's a little intimidating for somebody going in there.
This cocksucker's got nothing to lose. I want daddy come after me.
These guys make you feel warm. And you're not, and it's like a great friendly atmosphere. And so anybody who doesn't have any ink yet, this is the place I think you should go to get your first ink.
Right. And they're fantastic artists too. I've seen some of their work.
Which could be troublesome since we've already established no one in New Jersey listens to us. So you're going to have
somebody actually went and said that they used the promotion.
You have to travel. No, what did he get? Did they say?
It was actually a female. It was a female that they used to tell him Steve Dave Pucknuts promotion. And they were so happy and that they're going back for more work.
Wow.
And they were the friendliest, most
professional,
accommodating tattoo parlor they'd ever stepped into. And so what do you think, Sonny Joe?
Yeah, I've seen the work on Justin. He's definitely – I mean, I don't have any tattoos, but it's pretty impressive, the artwork that he's got on all of his
arms. Hoping somebody could send in a Pucknuts tattoo.
That would be awesome. I mean, you're definitely going to a game with us.
Yeah. Get a Pucknuts tattoo at Monarch and get free tickets to a double game.
Yeah.
With the Pucknuts.
With one of us.
That's a good promotion, right? Sunday, Jeff?
Oh, yeah. Get all the cookies you want.
It's probably easier than sending your Busted Nuts.
Yeah, well, less demeaning for sure.
How about a Busted Nuts promotion?
A little more permanent, but less
There's
demeaning.
There's no way I'm going to attend the game anybody
tattoo
sends
on
in
a Busted Nuts.
Busted Nuts in here. I'm not going anywhere near the person who sends it.
They're going to be sitting there with their pants off.
You never know.
They might get carried away.
Yeah, maybe.
So these Monarch people said they wanted to tattoo me,
Yeah, they wanted to. They came up with an idea where they would tattoo you live on a podcast. He was screaming and crying.
I never scream.
These guys are so good. They take the pain.
It's painless.
Out of tattooing.
Is that possible?
I don't know. I've gotten some tattoos. It depends on where you get it.
All right. Under the sack?
Yeah, I can get my sack tattooed in front of everyone.
All right.
I want it to somehow appear that it's hanging much lower so I can enter the Busted Nuts contest.
Just a little, all it takes is a little shadowing.
I have wanted to get something on like the underneath of my forearm right here.
Right.
So I got to think of something. Help me think of something, Walt, in the next...
Something horizontal?
In the upcoming
Can they bring
weeks.
Your tattoo equipment to the store and do it here?
I don't see why not.
Yeah, he said he could do it.
Yeah, that stuff's portable.
All right, so that's it. You're on for it? You're going to get a tattoo?
Yeah, I'll do it.
All right.
I'll do it.
We'll get that going.
I got to think of something good. We got to do a visual element, though, man.
All right. Well, I mean, you got
to get some video.
You got a bona fide artist sitting right to your left here. Get Walt to draw you something.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, well, you have his art on your arm already. All right, we'll figure something out.
Yeah, I already have a Walt Flanagan original.
I almost forgot about that.
All right.
You mentioned Facebook. Well, you said some preacher is...
Did you hear about that in Neptune? Some preacher in New Jersey wants all married couples to get off Facebook.
For?
because it's causing a lot of rifts and marriages.
Temptation.
Well, clearly. I mean, just it, as it evidenced does, by...
What do you mean? What, it Sunday does. Jeff, yeah, you have
Jeff was down at the midget house last weekend.
No. I'm not on Facebook. I'm not into it. All right. But there is people at work that have had problems.
Really?
Because of it, yeah.
This
because
work?
Of... Go I mean, I don't know...
The stash?
Go on.
No, nothing about here.
He meant it as other work, but he doesn't... Well, we can't say where Jeff works during the week.
It's, I guess,
Monday
I'm not,
through Saturday, Jeff.
I'm not familiar with a lot of the Facebook, but there's something called like the wall. I mean, you can post stuff on a wall or whatever. But if right. somehow or another, certain things have gotten and people have found out about things that they shouldn't have found out about.
What do you mean? Can you fucking elaborate? You're fucking.
Well, it's not 100% positive, but there's, again, there's been some, you know, problems as far as, I guess, intermarital, activities or,
somebody cheated?
Extramarital activities.
And they posted it on Facebook?
Not posted it, but I guess people have gotten like, you know, an idea. Well, you know, I think this is happening. And
so you're saying that their communications
yes,
have
their
been...
communications, like somebody's like, who is this person?
Well, who's the fucking idiot who puts it on the wall instead of like a message
or
something?
But that's the thing. I don't think it was. I mean, this one guy that's there, he's like saying, it's like, I didn't post this. It's just that, again, but if you have a
bunch
of friends...
Do you think he's full of shit?
Nah, he's pretty much on the, you know, I don't think so. I don't think so at all. But I guess
why would
when
he lie about
it,
that?
Yeah.
it's right there. It's on the walls. And just
why would he lie about it, though? You're like, you think he's full of shit? Like, why is he lying to Jeff about that he's got a fucking problem?
No, he showed me. Actually, it turned around and showed me like something what somebody else wrote to him. He's like, look at this. I said, I can't take this anymore. It's like, I did not send anything to this person. I said, they had to find out something. I said, you can't be on that stuff anymore, man. I said,
well, you got
to
be their friend or something.
Right. But I'm saying if you accidentally, again, I don't know how to use, you know, I'm on Facebook, but I guess it's like an email. If you send it to like one person, you can send it to everybody. Can you do it? Is it like that?
I don't know, man.
Man, you're
I'm not
Facebook,
a Facebook
right?
person.
I am.
So.
Are you getting off Facebook right now as we speak?
No, I don't think so. I think I'm going to stay on there.
Really? Did you?
I got nothing.
Now, earlier, you said that you have a password that you don't share with your wife, right? On Facebook.
Yeah. Why do I share my password with my wife?
Is she on Facebook? Every
she is. Yeah.
She share her password with you?
No, she doesn't.
Really? That's good.
Your secrets.
Because we've been going back and forth.
Me and
Debbie Chen.
What do you mean you got no secrets? Your password's a fucking secret, ain't it?
You just named one.
Sorry, excuse me.
But you guys, why wouldn't you guys give each other passwords?
I don't know. It's never come up. I don't care. I don't want a password.
Until Debbie Chen listens to Puck Nuts on it.
I think next week she knows that password.
It's new primo time slot.
All right, so you're saying all married couples listening to this right now, get off Facebook, go watch the
I'm
devil.
I'm not saying it. Well, yeah.
Okay.
But I'm not saying it. Some preacher said it in
right, but you
in
agree with
New
it.
Jersey. I believe that it is definitely for some couples
right,
a temptation
sure.
or a tool for evil.
Well, the evil. They're not fucking serial killing. They're flirting probably. But like you're on Facebook, Walt. I don't see it as being a problem at all for you. I think if your marriage is
what do you do on it though? I've never been on it.
Well, when you play Farmville, like Suzanne's been doing. But other than that, yeah, I mean, there's not much to do except like people update their status to like
what
you're
you
just
mean?
Like you fucking got to be
like
kidding
it's just
me.
Like a profile?
It's kind of like Twitter almost. Well, it's like you put your likes and your dislikes. Like you ever see MySpace? It's kind of like that.
Yeah, you post photos. On
you can
there.
Put your pictures
why
up
though?
There.
Why do people do that though? I don't understand the mindset of someone's like I need to show the world all that I like and I dislike, all my pictures.
It's a lot of information.
Who gives a fuck? Why does anybody care what
that's
your
the thing? I don't
are?
Think most people do. I don't think most people care about other people's stuff. But the country we live in now is so fucking has such a narcissistic bend to it that everyone is like. Pay attention to me. Just pay attention to me because I've got something that you need to see. I've got something you need to hear. Like, especially younger kids. Like, I was busting my nephew's balls the other day. I was putting shit on his Facebook account. And some of his friends, like, there are girls that have like 1,100 pictures of themselves up there, 400 pictures of themselves. And I'm like, why? Like, what is the point of all this?
See, yeah,
I don't get it either.
Out there, too, that this is just all like, you know, visible.
What can a predator do?
But if this stuff is, you know, you could pretend that you're a person or whatever that you're really not, and basically you could be soliciting.
If I were to admit who I really was,
it's a lot of information that these people put on some of these on these pages, and it's, you know, they're just asking for trouble, I guess, eventually.
I was just last night. I saw something. I know a couple. They have children. The girl's 14, and I saw a picture of her and a friend, and they're like, the picture is on a webcam on their profile.
Why the fuck on that are person's you on, profile on Facebook looking at people's profiles?
Because I was messing around with my nephew, like I said. And one of the pictures is of this girl and her friend, like, leaning over and, like, squeezing their tits together at 14. And like you say, that's, you know, a predator's going to get all hot and bothered and shit.
What can a predator do?
Like you said, like you
just get hot and bothered.
Well, you pretend you're somebody else and you write to them and you're like, hey, you know,
you
we
find
should
out where they live.
We should meet up. Yeah, because kids give fucking information all the time. Like my brother Darren, this is like 2 years ago.
Your brother's not a kid.
What's that?
Your brother's not a kid.
I know, but I'm afraid that, you know, he might get attacked by a predator. So I pretended I was someone else. No, he pretended he was someone else with my niece. Who was
to give
11
to
at the time. Yeah, and she failed.
Right.
She gave her fucking name and gave her phone number.
Wow.
You know, like dumb shit like that, you know?
All right, moral of the story, kids out there, if you're listening to this, don't post pictures
there
of yourself.
Ain't no kids.
Well, don't squeeze your tits together at least. Yeah. Together. Well, that's the thing. I'm like, do I tell this guy or do I, you know, it's none of my business.
It's none of your business.
Not my business, right? Okay. Unless I'm real close to him.
All right.
Like if I saw one of your kids doing something or your kid's doing something, I got to say something.
You're going to pipe up.
What's up?
You're going to pipe up.
I got to pipe up.
So that's it for this week then, right?
Not one shred of hockey talk yet.
Sad. We sound like a bunch of old men. All right. Let's start talking some hockey. All right. I'm not a superstitious guy, but I am 100% convinced that this Pucknuts curse that you brought up earlier is 100% true.
So there's ruined their season.
No, not against the Devils. Last week we blew Yaroslav Halak, goalie for the St. Louis.
What?
Yeah.
We all got down on our knees for this guy, and you know, we handed him the freaking Vezina Trophy. You know, right. In 20 games into the season, he had not lost a game. I think he was 8-0-1.
Right.
We recorded that episode on November 9th. November 10th gets lit up by the Blue Jackets. The Blue Jackets. He gets pulled in the second. Letting in 4 goals on 15 shots.
Shh.
Like, okay, that's an anomaly, right? Next game, loses in overtime to Nashville, 2-3. Next game, he lets in 6.
Wow.
Versus the Avalanche.
So how come when we talk about the Rangers, they don't freaking have bad luck?
Because we don't blow them. We
have to talk glowingly.
Yeah.
About them?
And then
I said Lundqvist owns the Devils.
All right, did you say that before the game or after? You said that after. You got to say it before these things happen. That's how the curse works.
You're just making shit up.
I know, he's broken it down.
I'm trying so bad to fucking make your bullet point work.
I highlighted these steps. Look at this.
You're getting thinner.
Halak has lost the last 4 games, not by a small margin. He let in 6 goals. Game after, he lets in 7. He let in 7.
All right.
After having his goals against average before this was something ridiculous, like 1.46. And now it's got to be way up by now. But that's got to be, dude. How else do you explain that?
Well.
I'm going to go on anything other than.
Than a curse.
Fucking four dimwits fucking sitting around a table in New Jersey having a factor on fucking Halak's.
You brought it up,
recent
though.
Record.
Spending a lion's share of the time talking about midget houses and used rubbers.
This isn't my curse. You brought it up last week or the couple of weeks ago.
I don't really believe in curses, though. Do you?
I mean, after seeing
any old ancient Chinese curses?
Ancient Chinese secrets? No, not really. Not really. If you look at my office, though, I do have this little like octagon
unicorn fucking horn.
Oh, grinding that
drink,
stuff.
That hey,
I think
out of.
I think that works.
Powdered tiger penis and curse of the dragon
keeps your fucking skin tight and fucking
that's
young.
That's not superstition.
Makes 110.
That stuff works. I just can't get my hands on any of that stuff.
Okay.
Stuff works. So I think, I think we should start kissing our opponents' asses before the games and see what happens.
All right.
At this point, how can it hurt?
I guess it can't.
It can't. So, So let's
we're recapping games that happened fucking it feels like a year ago.
I know, but you know there were notable
right when Kobe whiffs on the shootout goal. Did that happen? Literally, people listen to this.
It did happen two weeks ago. Yeah,
did it really?
Yeah,
8 days two weeks ago. Yeah.
Oh god.
Yeah, that was.
What's going up tonight?
Yes.
There's a game tonight, right?
There's a game tonight. Yes. Let's talk about that.
You want to talk up Toronto?
Yeah, let's not talk about shit. We can talk about the fact that they've been shut out now.
Three out of six
yeah. times.
Terrible.
Really?
Yes.
You weren't even excited, Walt, when they beat the Oilers.
No.
This week. I thought you would have been.
There was no excitement.
I almost wanted them to be embarrassed by the Oilers so they could just have to fire McLean. I just want him gone at this point. I can't stand listening to him go like, we did some good things, but, you know, we got to finish our chances. You know. He looks totally lost at this point.
During the games when they cut to him at the bench, yeah, he looks lost. He does not look confident.
I don't know. There's no coach that, although in his defense, there's no coach that's going to come in and have some sort of miracle for them to turn it around.
You don't think they'll shake anything up?
And unfortunately, there's only one thing they can do at this point other than make a trade. And I don't know if they'll even be able to make a trade. Who would want any of the dead wood that's on our team? But our team. I hate when people fucking say that. On that team.
Well, I mean, anybody tradable is injured right now. So, you know, they ain't going anywhere.
Is Brodeur back?
Yeah, he's back.
He's back.
Should have stayed fucking on the bench.
He's,
he's giving up goals left and right, man.
Nobody's scoring him, though, either.
Yeah.
He's still hurt today. He's still hurt though. You read today how he's got a new like elbow guard.
Do you think that Sunday Jeff still hurt from that puck that hit him a month ago? Is this a 40-some-year-old man or just cannot rebound from a puck hitting him, or is this any goaltender would have had that injury and been lagging this long?
Yeah, unless he's really – usually Brodeur plays. If he's hurt, he'll play. But, you know, this might be a little bit – it's obviously it's bothering him. If he's wearing braces and stuff, I think it's bothering him.
Debbie Chen called him out for being a wet puss hole 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, she did.
On this injury.
Is this injury caused by the fact that he's plus 40? Or is this an injury that would have affected a 20-year-old?
I would think it would have affected him either way. Yeah. Now, as far as recovery time, it might be a little bit different because of – I mean, as far as how much work he gets –
recovery time. It's been a month from a bruise.
It hasn't been that long.
They said it. What they said was a bruise. What they said was a bruise.
Yeah, watching him, it does feel like a month. It feels like the season's almost over already.
There's no excuse though for getting shut out. How many times? Fourth shutout in 11 games.
Three and six games in the last.
No, that was Tom. Yeah, that was Tom. Tim Thomas's stats.
Your bullet points are fucking blending in together.
Well, two times he shut out the Devils already. He got shut out the first time, didn't they? And they got shut out both times against Boston, I think, this year.
I think they put in one. They actually put in one.
They actually put a goal in against Boston.
They actually put it in first, which gave us some confidence.
But their roster, man, every day, it's just like you don't know who's playing. It's like a new team. Somebody's getting hurt. There's somebody in. This guy's out. This guy's back in Albany. This guy's back up. It's just no chemistry, no consistency, no goals.
I'm going to skip some of these other bullet points. Sorry, man.
Wait. You weren't the Edmonton victory. The first one at home. Finally, you had no shred of excitement.
Playing a last place team.
You're playing. It was like two.
That'll last.
Yeah, I mean, those goals against the Oilers, they were fairly solid, though. You got to admit that.
But they gave up how many goals, though? Like, I mean, it was just. You shouldn't be, and they were scoring goals so easily on the Devils too.
Yeah, all right. They went down 2-0 within the first 10 minutes. From their fourth line center, who I believe those were two.
Was that distasteful?
What, special ed kid?
Yeah.
I mean, to me or in general?
In general.
I mean, I don't think so.
I thought I phrased that properly.
You hesitated. You didn't go into it with salt and vinegar.
Speaking of special ed kids, Ming, I brought my own special ed kid, my niece. I thought she might help us break the Devil's Curse. She could be the new mascot. We're going to take a picture of ourselves with her and throw it up on the blog.
All right.
That'll change the curse around.
I'm hoping it will.
I think it will.
We're going to say. Curse.
All right. So everybody can, within the next couple of days, look at the blog our special little mascot.
Right next to the Busted Nuts.
It's kind of weird, though, that you got your picture of your niece and then you got it right next to it is.
It won't be next to it.
Nuts yet. Can you, put a healthy distance between those?
Scroll down. What's this?
There's a new kind of curse going on there.
this beautiful kid, and then you scroll down. Oh my lord,
the curse of family services. Coming in. No, no, you don't understand.
You, I don't know. Maybe.
How do we do it? You'll be able to figure it out.
Yeah, I'll put a healthy distance.
I trust you.
It's on the same page.
I'll figure out a way. All right.
How about you put a link on the front page, and then it'll and then it'll don't put the busted nuts on the open page because then that way you gotta see it.
Listen, if you really want to see his busted nuts, you'll make an.
Who's gonna gotta go see it anyway, though?
You're gonna find it.
Who literally really wants to see that?
You put a hit counter on her.
We can do that too.
A counter.
How many people you can tell me people went and looked at your blog?
Yeah. I think there's stats somewhere. I don't know. I haven't looked.
Yeah, right.
Started off at 2000.
I don't believe that. You haven't checked it out.
It's somewhere. I haven't looked. It really didn't concern me.
He's busy.
Okay.
Coming up with bullet points.
I was excited. I mean, I was at the game.
Yeah. Well, you should be excited. You went to every game so far. You've seen them lose. Finally, you get to see win.
Yeah.
It's okay for you to get excited. But don't get, like, unrealistic, though. You're it's done. We're turning
around. No. I'm not going to be one of those guys who
– Look who they beat up.
Yeah.
Because then the next game that the Edmonton Oilers played, they got eight scored on them against the Rangers.
Right, Eric had a hat trick first game.
Yeah,
back.
So, I mean, the Devils struggled mightily to a team that just got blew out the next game they played. So.
Right. It was nice seeing Kovalchuk kind of redeem himself that game, though, with the overtime winning goal.
You would think he won the Olympics, though, the way he was pumping that fist and going skating all over the place.
I did the same thing in the aisle, except, I didn't slide. I couldn't slide that far. My daughter was looking.
Was your daughter excited, or was she like, "What the fuck? What are you doing?"
No. She was wondering why there was a fourth period.
My dad's having a seizure.
She was wondering why there was a fourth period, though. I think she wanted to go home at that point. But
yeah. Oh, she realized that there was an extra period.
Yeah, she's like, "There's supposed to be a fourth period." I'm like, "Yeah." When the
look, a sharp little tech that one. Hell, is she five?
She's five.
Well, look at her.
Upcoming matchups, Ming.
All right, upcoming matchups.
Sunday, Jeff.
I don't know.
Where do you pencil a win in and get the next three games?
All right. So
who do they play after the Caps?
The fuck? You look at your bullet points.
It only goes to the Caps. Oh. Who do they play after the Caps?
That's 1 week.
When do they play the Islanders? When do they?
You know the Islanders are going to break that streak when they play.
I don't know, but they got rid of their coach real quick, didn't they?
Yeah.
But didn't take them too long.
You know what? If the Devils were on the Islanders' schedule, that 11-game streak would be over because they are going to come in, and then you know it's going to be, like, bad.
They've played no weak teams at all. Every team they've played is tough. Every team's
Toronto's
a good team.
Toronto's under 500.
They started the season off good. St. Louis is a good team. Capitals are a good team now.
Capitals are a very good team.
They played the Caps good. They played them good at the beginning of the season, and they just fell apart.
What? What are you talking about?
Fucking setting?
They were tied in the second period. Then it fell apart. Weren't they tied 2-2 in the second period?
Whoa. They fall apart every second period. So.
Well, then obviously there's a problem with the Devils, isn't there? Now, I'm starting to slowly agree with Walt that there should be time for coaching change. I like John McLean, but you know what?
What do you like about him?
Well, I like him as a player, and I think that he deserved his chance to be coach. And I'm not saying that he's not capable of it. It's just that obviously a change. If you cannot change anything else on the team now, he's the last resort to change. You have to do something to change the team's mentality if they're not going to play for you. You know, and I think they're trying. It's just that different lineups every night. It's just a mess. It really is. It's a freaking clusterfuck.
Well, I see a bullet points here. It says, "Well, the new lines work." Is that what these guys are doing? Do they keep changing the lines
in an attempt to?
They really have to, though, because there are so many injuries.
What do you think of that line, Zubrus, Kovey, and
Vasyunov? Yeah. You know what? At this point, I assumed that line had already been tried already. There's been so many lines, so none of these lines.
But look, Elias is on the last line now. They're gonna put Elias on the third line.
Yeah. I mean, at this point, I know they're not scoring goals, but boy, I would be more concerned about the defense. It's fucking hard.
Yeah.
It's terrible.
It just guys just way out of position
all the time.
How'd Bryce Salvador get a concussion? How'd that happen?
That was from last
year.
Somebody
punched him in the head. No, it was in a preseason.
Somebody punched him?
Yeah. He got punched.
He got punched in the head. He also got rammed into the boards too. Like it was a combination of three big hits. You ever have a concussion? Anybody here?
I'm getting concussion watching them play. That's where my concussions come.
Have you had one?
I think I had a mild concussion actually playing hockey years ago. It was the only time I ever felt my brain move.
Really?
Yeah.
Like bouncing around in
that? The only time I ever felt my brain move. I felt it really slush around in my head.
What?
There was a guy coming across the blue line, and I wasn't playing defense, but like
so that street league you used to play in?
And he was cutting across the blue line. He didn't see me coming, and we were allowed to check. So he's cutting across the blue line, and I'm coming the other line. I see him. And I'm like, oh my god, I'm gonna line this guy up, he's not gonna see me, and I'm gonna railroad him. At the last minute, he saw me, and he was wearing a helmet. And he's like in this street hockey league, nobody wore helmets, and it was just weird that he was wearing a helmet. He saw me, and he picked his head up, and he picked his fucking forearm up, and hit me right in the head with it. And I really felt like my brain slush around for a second.
Oh my god!
And then, like that night though, I felt really strange.
Right to the ground.
Bebby's like, sleep, Walter, yeah. Sleep.
Just like over there, just like seeing like a blur of the guy. Whoa, it was a
really
okay?
weird feeling, man. Yeah. And
did your team go after him for doing that?
No, it wasn't like that. League, no,
no old time hockey.
Nobody wanted. I mean, it was like it was like almost like a beer league kind of thing. Everybody had jobs the next day. Nobody fucking really wants to get injured and shit.
Yeah, that's fucked up though. Like imagine like you got a serious like brain injury. Like if you have that guy that we used to play with. Remember when we used to play down at the rec and. There was a guy we played hockey with, and he got hit in the head with a chair or something, or he hit somebody with a chair. Remember, he was in high school, and he was slow. Yeah, I think somebody hit him over really the head with a chair. But like, I thought his speech patterns were slow and shit. I don't know. No. Maybe I'm misremembering.
There was one guy we played with. I remember he said that he got drunk. Not drunk. It wasn't drunk. That would be disparaging him. He fell asleep at the wheel. He got into an accident and he got catapulted from the car and he like 25, 30 feet and not one injury.
Oh my god.
Because he was sleeping.
He was all lax and stuff. Yeah. Maybe that's why.
He didn't.
And he hit the ground. He just woke up and he's just like, he hit the ground. And he just said that he had dirt that in his ears that didn't come out for weeks. He said that he did not one injury about that.
Was he the goalie?
No.
Oh, do you remember the goalie? I think I can't remember.
Yeah, I remember the goalie.
He threw up.
He kept throwing up all the time.
In his mask.
Yeah, we had a goalie kept throwing up.
Where is he? Was he nervous?
I don't know. They would drink before the games.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it wasn't Brodeur, was it?
No. And he would if he couldn't get to the sidelines to throw up, he just threw up in his mask then.
Like, it would like trip out.
Yeah.
For what reason? Yeah, I mean, it's like, was he just like moving back and forth?
Like, call a timeout, man. He just had to throw up. And what is he going to do?
Right, you can't leave the net. Wow.
What I'm saying is, it because he's like physically going back and forth, or is he just like, I just ate pizza like 2 seconds before I went to play a game
of drinking beer, 95 degree weather, and
getting ejected from his car.
Yeah, he would just vomit.
I guess nobody was in the crease.
We were hardcore, man. That's how we used to play.
All right.
So that it, man?
No, you want to talk about the story about the new seats between the benches?
I didn't hear about this story.
There are four teams in the NHL have taken that spot between the benches, right. And they've opened it up to spectators.
Right.
They've installed four seats in there. Minnesota, Tampa Bay, Nashville, and Columbus opened up that ultra premium seating.
Okay. How much does these seats run for?
So not without a price, though. If you go to Minnesota, they will cost you, they will run you a cool $2,400.
For one game?
For one game. Ooh. Now, that's not just the seats. I think that comes with a package where you get a tour of the press box.
You get a game puck, a jersey, an on-ice photo after the game.
Yeah, but still, I don't know. That adds up to $2,400.
Just let you drive the Zamboni for that price. You know what?
I think every league, I mean, every team should do this.
What's usually between there? I've never even really noticed.
I don't think anything's there.
I think they just butt right next to each other.
Usually, some arenas, though,
press box or something, isn't it? Like just to take photos?
Yeah, I don't know. But
should Kevin reserve those seats for the Puck Nuts for the season?
Did you hear how many people were at the Islander game last night?
No.
8,000.
Whoa.
Wow.
How many does that hold, that arena?
Probably 16, I would imagine.
Whoa.
But, I mean, I'm not even saying it as like, ha-ha. I'm just saying that, like, I would imagine that all attendance in sports has got to be, like, just nosediving at this point with the economy, with –
You don't want to go to see them lose.
Well, yeah, they're on an 11-game losing streak. That plays into it. Mm. It's got to be – even if – Even if you're one of the upper echelon teams playing really well, I mean, who has the money to go see games in this day and age?
I think Chicago. So doesn't Chicago sell out all their games? Well, Austin's usually pretty good. Toronto. Toronto sells out a lot of
well,
their
that's
games.
Toronto.
And Montreal. But still, I mean, economy's economy wherever you go.
Economy, yeah, I understand, but man, I don't know.
That's expensive.
I got a feeling that in the next 10 years, especially if things get worse, you are going to see dramatic decreases in tickets. And what was I talking about?
Tickets, the, low attendance.
Low attendance, yeah. Ticket price, your concussion is.
He waved to me and my mind went blank.
It's happened to me before.
What was I talking about?
You're talking about the.
Yeah, I got to imagine that. Oh, man, I lost my thought.
Yeah, that's all right.
Would be decreasing over the next couple of years.
Yeah,
over the years.
I mean, the teams will have to adjust and have to fix the prices of the tickets so that people will fill the arena up.
The answer is not to start charging $2,400 for two seats for a game.
I would imagine, no, that can't be the answer.
But why would you do that in those markets? Why wouldn't you do it in, like, Detroit, Boston, or Chicago, where those seats might be readily, you know, that you would probably sell those out, though, you know, rather than a market.
I think they should do it everywhere.
Well, isn't this the one where the fan, was that Minnesota with the fan?
Yeah, it was, actually.
So maybe they're trying to get rid of those other seats so that'll never happen again and maybe put these in the middle and give something else, you know, people like, oh, take these primo seats for $2,400.
Do you think that that it's a domino effect and then the salaries of athletes will go down too?
I can't believe that that's not where they have kind of started, like, pinching pennies.
No, it seems like they don't. It seems like they still – like GMs in all sports are overpaying players. Not overpaying, but
the
contracts that are being thrown around are insane. What about McNabb? Did you see what
–
guy who can't even remain a starter just got that gigantic contract.
Yeah. Was that 18 mil?
But that's football. Isn't hockey like on the bottom of the list as far as high-paid professional sports?
Oh,
I mean, the guy golfers, I think, actually make more money than some of the players.
I understand what you're saying, but like – I would just think across the board in every sport, you would start to see that the salaries have got to come down as people are just can't go to the games anymore. It's just got so out of reach for people to attend.
But you can cut people in the NFL. That's where we were talking about that with the unions, how they could just, like, you know, just cut you and then they don't have to pay for your salary. So that's a little bit of a difference. So you can offer them those big contracts, and if you're not performing or whatever,
well,
they give
there is some guaranteed money for McNabb.
Yeah,
though.
There is
big money for a guy that you couldn't even. He didn't even. The coach was benching him and wouldn't even let him play on the last 2 minutes of a game of the game they could have won. It's insane. I don't know how. I just don't know how you can justify the contracts that are being given out when attendant. I don't know about the NFL. I'm sure they ain't hurting for
no, not at all
at their games, but.
It says here,
certainly.
In regard to these seats, it says hockey has their very own equivalent of the home plate phone douche. What's that?
I have no idea what that means.
That's a great question.
Is that what that is? I think it's when you got – because home. If you're sitting behind home plate.
Oh, right. They got the cell phone.
You're on TV constantly because that is the primo angle for a baseball game. Everything is shot from behind the pitcher.
Yeah, those idiots behind.
It's a seating equivalent of a Thursday night podcast.
Yeah. You're going to get so much FaceTime. And I guess they're tired of, like, I guess the people are like, how the fuck are you paying so much money to sit behind home plate? And for the most part, people are just on their cell phone.
Talk
on
a phone.
Yeah. Like, why are you people on cell phones after paying those exorbitant prices?
They're waving to their friends at home watching on TV.
Yeah, you see
those assholes, you know, waving. There you go.
You got a nice buffet here too, man. This would interest you. All you can eat steak, crab legs, prime rib.
Cookies?
Doesn't mention cookies.
All right, Sunday Jeff's out.
I'll tell you what, though. Like, you get to sit right next to the players. So if, like, you bought these tickets at a Rangers game, you could watch them eat nuts.
See you next week.
Find more funny shit like this at Smodcast.com. Scott, when I'm not recording Smodcast,
what are you doing?
Listening to Smodcast.com. Not just our show, but there are six other great shows that you can listen to all for free every day of the week.
7 days a week.
It's just like a real network that only ran one show that was only an hour long and had no picture.
It was like the beginning. It was like Milton Berle.
Yes. This is like Texco Start, but even they had a picture. We're dialing it way the fuck back. This shit's so low tech. Oh, totally.
We're the shadow.
Absolutely, man. This is the Green Hornet time where it's just like, and then the Green Hornet entered the room.
Hello.
See how riveting that shit is? That's what's happening all the time at smodcast.com. It's theater of the mind,
people
bitch.
Entry.
People come in. People say shit. People leave.
Smodcast.com.
Good call. Yes, good callback. Smodcast.com. It's all free. It's all funny. It's monsters of talk.